5 technology.
What's your staff temp? What's that measuring?
That's the oil. That's your internal oil out of the jet.
It's hot.
Oh, no, it's hot on the hot. Ones that it's are hot. Not working.
Time. The two of them, those yeah. two jets aren't even there, so.
Oh, right. So that's just those, the air value.
Yeah,
or whatever.
It's just an air. Okay. They usually run around 200 degrees.
Okay.
That makes more sense.
Yeah. You're looking at it, you're like 2200.
Well, we do some ridiculous number to let us know that it's
sure.
incomplete signal.
Right. Makes yeah. perfect sense. Yeah.
Then I have to have all the jets at 1050, 1050 RPM before we can progress. And then I got a 2-minute purge. So when that hits 120 seconds, all these, they're called stop cock valves. And they'll open, and that's where the gas goes to the jet.
So okay.
they'll try to light off.
Okay. So right now, the only thing is that they're just rolling.
They're just spinning.
The hydraulic motor's doing its job, okay. spinning everything.
And it's actually starting to roll the generator.
Okay.
I'm up to about 7 RPM. And then I think it's number 8 engine. I have to go back there and push the relay in to get it to go.
It looks like number 1 engine and number 4 engine are...
Can you go fork on that real fast?
I'll go get them started.
Can you go get those started?
Okay, I'll be right back.
Get the engine crank on.
So you get extra vibrations because you don't have the uniform?
It really is not enough to matter. They do have all kinds of rules. We're not supposed to run with two holes empty next
right,
to each
like
other.
Right, one and two off would be bad.
And they like the holes to be opposite.
Sure.
To
how,
equal,
did, and how did you find that out?
Some old guy wrote it down somewhere. When I walked in here, there was pictures and stuff. Okay. I did get to spend about a year and a half with one of the guys that was involved. He came from GE and involved in it.
Okay.
He was 80s at that time.
Okay.
And, but when he died, all that information went away.
We're up to 15 RPM.
Oh, yeah, we're rolling now. We're getting ready to light off.
I'm going to be watching this.
No, they have to be about 350 degrees. Kind of
hey,
Janine.
Yeah.
He was right. He knows this.
There you go.
It just flicks on.
It's good.
Did that temperature come up on that
one? Yeah, 800.
So I got it.
35 RPM.
I have 2 steps to catch that. 2 tries per 2 steps, so 4 tries to light the jet. After that, you're done. You have to shut everything back off and start over. And
so would you run on 7 then, or would you start over?
7's okay. You're just not supposed to run with less than 7.
Gotcha.
Because that gets you to that number where you can never have 2
right.
next to each other.
Right.
Okay. 6 puts you in a position where you're going to have 2 next to each other.
So yeah, if like 2 or 5 was the one that didn't light off, then you'd have to shut down anyways because it's next to one that's missing. Right?
You're supposed to, yes. We did just have 7 jets until recently when these guys, we got another one, they put it in. And I had some times over the summer where I was down to 5 jets and I haven't shut them.
Wow.
Because even though you get them lit, get them running, 20 minutes down the road doesn't mean they're still running.
Yeah.
And I don't have enough information. They just stop running. I have no idea why. And nothing tells me why. So you got to start figuring out.
So you don't really have diagnostics in the engine?
No, right? There is none. This is all the information I have.
Exhaust gas temperature?
That's it.
What's your discharge pressure?
That's the, we usually run around a full load, about 115, 120.
Okay.
And that's all set based on there's rings and orifices to give you enough thrust not to hurt the bearing, but you know, so you got your thrust bearing, so you don't want to thrust it hard.
Right.
So you have to create some sort of back pressure to come back. You guys already know all that stuff. So we just do that with orifices off our exhaust.
Oh, okay, sure.
That's the starters kicking off. They kick off around 3,400 RPMs on the jets. Here's the jets.
Okay.
Also.
What's operating RPM for the turbine?
1,200.
1,200.
This is a 6-speed.
Climbing pretty quick.
Oh, so you need to stay at 1,200 frequency, right then?
Correct. 1,200 is a gear ratio. Everything in the United States is 3,600. So everything's going to be based on that. Like that turbine over there, the gear ratio of that spins at 900.
Okay.
It's all got to be that, just like this one's 1,200.
Okay.
They're all going to be a factor of that 3,600.
Okay.
Now those actually over there spin at 3,600 generators.
Okay.
And those jets over there run around 9,000 RPMs, and these run around 8,700. It's spinning, but not lit. Not lit.
Okay.
And you don't have a shot now to go again without resetting the whole system.
I have to shut everything off and start over. We're not doing that. We're just gonna. I'm not loading it today anyway.
Right, yeah, you're not making power,
so,
right?
So, I'm just really drying the jets out a little bit. We get up to about 450, you'll start hearing some click, click, and that's the gas valves that are 1965 gas valves. I should show you that because it's all oil and air driven.
Cool.
It's unbelievable. But that'll be them increasing to give it gas.
Okay.
It'll be happening any moment. Real straight lines on that grill.
No. Big fun.
It's like 10 gallon out of something.
Yeah. It's an old jet. That's one of the original 102s. Not original, but our when I took over.
Uh-huh. Okay. Huh.
Do you know how much gas you're using?
No, I have no clue. I've got gas meters and stuff, but they're so inaccurate.
Oh, okay.
And then we're going to start the excitation part of this here in just a minute. We'll start seeing the sink scope go and all that kind of stuff, and I'll stop it before it actually sinks, because this thing automatically sinks itself, and it doesn't necessarily have to be exact. It can also make you puffer. Because on a sink scope, you can't close the breaker until it's dish top. That's where you're in phase with everything
else. Right, so you're not thrown off the grid.
Correct. And here's our generator breaker that we would close to do so. But this thing will close.
Oh.
It's quite fun at that time. So instead of 1,200, I'm a little short. That's why we're slow.
Okay, right. Right, sure.
So if I go above that speed, it'll spin the other way.
Right.
Yeah.
It's a good way to show it.
Yeah.
It's a nice, well-designed gauge.
All our units have this. Steam units, all that, they're all, they got this.
Huh.
I'm only running at 60 pounds of gas. I got 300 pounds supply, but at this speed, I'm only using 60 pounds. Full load, I'm closer to the 2 something mark.
Okay.
210.
Okay. So I'm running at
especially
25% or so.
That's good.
All the opposite out there.
Go ahead. No seat.